Tūana au ki te tihi o te maunga tapu mauau, ka te tiro whakararo ki ngā waipirata rata o taranga moana. Te awa iti, te awa nui, te unga mai o te waka takiti mui. Nei rā, a piri rākau e tauana, uri o ngā tūrangi nui. Tēnā tātou, ko Pianika Teru, Ida Ray Ormsby tēnei.
Before I was born, my whānau was living on a farm in Huntley. There were my mum and dad and five tamariki. They were real young parents with heaps of babies, and then I came along.
It wasn't planned. It was planned not to be.
Yeah, actually we were trying not to have children this time and taking quite big precautions, didn't we? So it was a real big surprise, a millennium surprise.
I was born at the hospital on the doorstep. I think it just fell out.
I got right into the doorway and I just opened up, spread my legs apart, and Travis was sprinting off trying to get the midwife and she just fell out.
Yeah, couldn't wait to come into this world, I think.
Pianika was blessed today, and I hope the church will play a really big role in her life.
My parents were always going to the church, so I was born into the church as well.
We attend the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I have been brought up in that church and it's definitely part of my life.
It teaches us where we came from and where we're going in the life after, and teaches you to be a good person.
Yeah, the church was a big part of our lives, and we always had like family home evenings on Sundays or another night, and we always did like karakia together.
It's our humble prayer in the name of thy beloved son Jesus Christ, amen.
You're kind of like in a community where whānau is really important.
Karanga mai, karanga mai, karanga mai.
I hope that baby will appreciate things Māori and be comfortable in coming on a marae and be happy to be Māori.
I was actually the first sibling, so the first baby out of all of us to go to kohanga.
Mainly because there was a beautiful kohanga down here at Te Puna, and the whānau were lovely and I really liked the kaiako.
Owe, he puru! Ka uma ia.
I was the first baby to learn te reo in our whānau, so I kind of wasn't exposed to it at home, but at school I was definitely exposed around our reo. And yeah, I think for mum and dad, seeing their baby grow up in reo, yeah, must have changed something for them.
I guess my attitude towards things Māori have changed. I see it's being really important to learn te reo Māori because it is part of our culture, and I see now that it was lost because of colonisation. We're just at Maunga Tapu School and we're at the Rā Whakangaho, which is an event held every year.
E pai ki a hei tōku moko nā tmea i ētahi wā i heikana a hei. I nervous a hei nā tmea kei te haere mātai ki ringa i te stage.
Oh, I feel really proud when she's performing and excited for her, and hopefully that she's not too nervous or anything like that. Yeah, just proud mum.
Turning 14, I started at a mainstream kura, and then I think I started playing rugby with a whare kura.
And then next minute she's saying, I want to go to the wharekura now.
I just liked
being with them, like they made feel like family.
I roto I te reo Pākehā he passive.
Mum rang up and I had an interview with their principal. The principal was talking Māori to me and I thought it was pretty cool talking that much Māori because I hadn't in a while.
I take my hat off to her, all her teachers that she's had in the past because I never taught her the reo. It was from them and she's, you know, maintained it. Mm.
Do you know what we're doing tonight?
Oh, we're making quiche. We go to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints every most Sundays.
There's lots of things that we should do or do as children of God, and one of them is about looking after that temple he's given us, which is our bodies. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Amen.
I think we gain our own choice once we leave home.
We haven't had any resistance from Pianika. She's just is carrying on going to church.
I think after school I can imagine myself going to university. A good age to get married. Probably 21-ish. Or 22-ish. I didn't think I would have kids already by then.
Oh, I hope Pianika hasn't had kids by 21 or anything like that. I hope that's, you know, way in her future.
Mum and Dad, they just stopped going to church, which was like out of it, I think, because we always would go every single Sunday. And as a 14-year-old, I was just kind of going with it. I didn't really question why.
I did end up going to university again and studied Indigenous cultures and languages. And I just learned how religions came here way back, and it was like a little bit of a form of colonisation. And I realised how colonised I was as well, my thinking and my own personal biases, and I didn't like it.
They've changed a lot. Yeah, life has changed for all of us.
My partner, Tātai, we met in Wharekura and then we went to uni together, and my plan was to become a dentist and study dentistry.
After the first year, I decided to take a gap year. I was planning on travelling, and so I was working, saving up some money, and then COVID came. We had to think about something different that we wanted to do. We were pretty open to having a baby, and then it ended up happening.
Feels real hard right now.
Yeah. So you're getting some of those tightenings?
Yeah.
Yep, so yeah. You know about the Braxton Hicks, the practice contractions.
Yeah.
My parents were really excited as well. They were kind of surprised. They were surprised, yeah. But happy. They were beyond happy, I'd say.
Someone described having mokopuna as, if you think of your heart, it grows another layer.
The kaupapa that I'm kaiarahi or facilitator of is he pikarere, and where it comes from is the whakataki, he pipi papa noho kohanga he pikarere.
I was always in the Māori unit, and then I went into mainstream, and then I went back into wharekura at college, and then back into mainstream. So I kind of had the best of both worlds. Yeah, I think the benefit of having both was that you get to see what things are like in two totally different places. I guess looking at my nannies, who weren't allowed to be Māori, you kind of feel more proud to be. And yeah, I think that's a huge part of our lives now, which I'm grateful for. We named him Tangaroa because he was born on the Tangaroa marama. Everything that we plan is for baby, and I guess we think about our future more importantly now. It's more of a priority. I would like to be one of those mamas that you can go to for anything. You like tell them whatever you want, just feeling comfortable. I just want him to be proud of who he is and not have any worries best of both worlds as well.
Kia ora te whānau, just want to present this taonga to Pianika for her 21st birthday. So, present this to you, your birthday.
Thanks everyone for coming. It's been nice to have, I just expected our family to be here, but yeah, it is nice knowing that. That you're loved by all your whānau.
I hope that my mokopuna can, like I do think of my tupuna, I hope that in the future they can look at us and be inspired, that they're Māori, that they are proud of their heritage.
They had so many kids, so they did the best job they could. Just being a parent right now, you just understand. So I'm like happy the way they raised me. I think my parents did a great job.